Hi, Mystery Recapped here. Today, I'm going to explain an American action crime thriller film called Safe. Spoilers ahead, watch out, and take care. In Nanjing, China, lives a little girl named Mei. She is a gifted mathematician who can solve complicated mathematical problems in her head. She also has a great memory and never forgets any series of numbers she comes across. One day, Mei is walking home with her friends when a group of men abducts her. She is taken to a Chinese mafia leader named Han. The digital data of Han's criminal enterprise is traceable, hence he wants to use Mei as his personal mental calculator who can memorize the data for him. Initially, the little girl refuses to cooperate, but when he threatens to kill her mother, she agrees to do as told. Under the care of their trusted gang member, Chang, Mei is brought to New York, where she is hidden as his daughter. Somewhere else, in New Jersey, former cop and cage fighter, Luke, is in an intense match with his opponent. He has set the match up and is supposed to lose, but he accidentally throws a good punch at his opponent and knocks him out straight into a coma. The win angers the head of the Russian mafia, Emil, who lost millions of dollars on Luke. Luke realizes that an angry gangster would mean that his family is in trouble. He rushes home, but is too late, because the Russians rushed faster. The gangster's son, Vasily, has already killed his pregnant wife. Luke is devastated by the death, and although he can fight, he doesn't retaliate. The thugs then promise to kill anyone with whom he speaks to or makes contact. With nowhere and no one to go to, Luke returns to his hometown, New York. He starts living as a homeless person, wandering around in the streets of Manhattan. 1 year later, Mei is still working with the gang. Chang takes her on a weekly round of the streets in Chinatown. She memorizes the percentage of net profit or loss every store faces. The store owners are supposed to pay the gang a certain amount of money according to their profit. Hence, Mei is proven to be a useful asset to them. Throughout her time working with the gang, she has learned a lot about how business works in the gangster world. Somewhere else, Luke lives in a highly unorganized homeless shelter. One night, he meets a man with no shoes and severely infected feet. Out of sympathy, he gives the man his new shoes, but the next day, he wakes up to discover that someone slit the poor guy's throat and stole the shoes overnight. Suffice to say that Luke's living conditions are poor. Meanwhile, a lady working closely with Chang approaches Mei in the middle of the night and informs her of her mother's death back in China. It turns out that she was severely sick and in hospital. The following day, the leader of the gang, Han, comes to New York for the first time since he sent Mei. He has come with a piece of paper with a series of numbers on it. Mei is asked to memorize the number, which she does in less than 10 seconds. The numbers seem to be of great importance because Han burns the piece of paper to ashes, so only Mei would know what they are. After that, Chang takes her to the next location. Mei is told that she will have to memorize the second series of numbers when she reaches the destination. Everything goes according to plan until they are attacked by the Russian mafia, led by Emil, the gangster who killed Luke's wife. They are also after Mei because of the numbers she has memorized. A shootout ensues where the Chinese gangsters lose to the Russians, who abduct Mei. Somewhere else, Luke is having a bad day because a passerby stole his breakfast money. While trying to buy something, he bumps into his former colleague from the police force. The man instantly recognizes Luke and takes him to an abandoned building with his fellow cops. A long time ago, Luke debunked their corrupt ways of helping the local gangsters. The cops are still furious at him for getting them in trouble back then. They beat him up and insult him, but he doesn't retaliate. In the end, a cop hands Luke a gun, urging him to end his own life. But Luke refuses and walks away. At the same time, Mei is taken to the Russian gang leader, Emil, who asks her about the numbers. She soon finds out that the lady who told her about her mother was helping Emil the entire time. The lady also asks Mei to tell them the code, but in turn, Mei claims that the woman is going to die because she doesn't know how business works. Right afterwards, the men shoot her dead since she is of no use to them anymore. Mei knows she will suffer the same fate if she tells them the number, hence she keeps quiet. Just then, a corrupt cop and one of Luke's former colleagues, Captain Wolf, comes to the Russian hideout to catch the criminals. However, he is not doing it for the law, but on the orders of the Chinese leader, Han. Emil calls the captain and offers him double the money than the Chinese gangsters to get away from his hideout. The corrupt captain accepts the deal and retreats. By this time, Mai has run away from the hideout without anyone seeing her. Both the Russians and Chinese gangsters start looking for her in hopes of finding her before the other group does. Mai eventually reaches the subway station where Luke is about to end his life. He is seconds away from jumping on the tracks when he locks eyes with the scared little girl and stops himself. He also notices the gangsters who killed his wife looking for the little girl. To run away from them, she gets on the subway, but the gang gets a glimpse of her and follows. Luke realizes something is wrong and makes it his mission to save the girl. He latches onto the subway and kills all the Russians on his way. One of them recognizes Luke as the guy they beat up a year ago. He is surprised as to how someone so submissive can defeat all their people in minutes. In the end, he is also killed, and Luke finally meets Mai. But as soon as the subway stops, she runs away with the crowd, mistaking Luke for one of the bad guys. On his way to look for her, Luke overhears a red alert code being relayed to all the cops. He registers that the girl is also wanted by the corrupt policemen, who will definitely hand her to the mafia. A few minutes in, two cops who beat up Luke earlier find the girl and try to take her away. Luke arrives at the right time and knocks them out in an instant, proving that he was staying quiet only because he wanted to. Mai still doesn't trust him, but gets into a car with him when the Russian mafia arrives. A high-speed car chase ensues in the streets of Manhattan. At last, Luke kills all the Russians, steals their wallets, and takes Mai to a fancy hotel. Somewhere else, the captain finds out that Mai was taken by force, not by the mafia, but by Luke. He is in shock because Luke hasn't been involved in anything crime-related since he left the police force. Meanwhile, after checking into the hotel, Mai starts to trust Luke and tells him about the numbers she memorized. Upon checking the format of the numbers, he figures out that it is the combination of a safe. Mai says she was supposed to memorize a second sequence before the Russians attacked, which means there are two safes with something valuable in them, probably being traded by the Chinese mafia. Just then, Chang finds out Mai's location using a tracking device in her phone. He and his henchmen arrive at the hotel and start a shootout. Chaos ensues as people start to run for their lives. Eventually, Luke gets into a fistfight with the gangsters, which causes him and Mai to separate. Chang gets his hands on her while Luke escapes before he is killed. He knows that he cannot leave Mai alone and is ready to do anything to get her back safe. So he calls the Russian leader Emil's son, Vasily, from a phone he stole earlier. Vasily is also the guy who killed Luke's wife a year ago. Luke pretends to be their gang member and claims that he has the number that everyone is looking for. Vasily believes him and calls him to a casino to deliver the said number. Somewhere else, the city's mayor calls the corrupt police captain to his office to discuss all the shootings. It turns out that he and his boyfriend Alex are also just as corrupt as the others. The mayor reveals that Luke wasn't a normal cop. In fact, he was a CIA agent loaned to the police force after 9/11. While he was in the police force, he and his former partner Alex assassinated several crime bosses in an effort to impose order. However, Luke had to quit after exposing the corrupt ways of the captain and his squad. Alex stayed and seduced the mayor to get where he is now. The captain finally realizes that the guy he thought was a loser is actually the most dangerous enemy he has ever had. Currently, Luke's former partner Alex is the mayor's boyfriend who has gone corrupt like him. When the mayor is informed about Mai and Luke being together, he gets nervous. It is almost as if he knows something about the safe and the combination on it. In the meantime, Mai is brought back to the leader Han, who inquires if she told the combination to anyone. She lies and insists that she pretended to not understand English. Chang calls Alex and tells him that they have the girl, so they can continue the meeting. It is then revealed that the people the Chinese mafia was trying to do business with are the mayor and his boyfriend, Alex. They are trading the unknown contents of their respective safes, kind of like selling unopened boxes of Pokemon cards. Next, Luke arrives at the casino, where he finds the Russian gangsters. He ambushes all of Vasily's henchmen and takes them hostage, planning to use them to threaten the Russian leader, Emil. He calls Emil and asks him about the contents of the safe in exchange for his son's life. Emil discloses that the safe with the Chinese gangsters has $30 million in it, while the safe with the mayor has something that is worth the aforementioned money. The parties were about to trade using the little girl, but the Russians stepped in and destroyed the plan. However, now that the Chinese have Mai, the plan is back on track. Chang goes to meet Alex and exchange the codes. Now, the only way for Luke to save the girl is by getting the $30 million from the Chinese mafia before the trade takes place. But he cannot do it on his own because the safe is hidden deep in Chinatown and protected by the most dangerous of the Chinese gangsters. So, he asks for help from his former cop colleagues. They agree to help, but only because of the money. The group then walks into the hideout and starts a shootout. On the way, several gangsters and cops die. But not Jason Statham, because he still has to fistfight some more people. When they finally reach the locker, Luke betrays the cops and shoots them dead, except the captain, who he holds hostage alongside Vasily. He also takes the money from the safe and makes his way to the mayor's office. On his way, he calls Alex and asks him what is in the second safe. Because Luke has the money, Alex is bound to do everything he asks. He reveals the second safe belongs to the mayor, containing a disc with data on every crime syndicate in New York. The mayor wanted to sell it to the Chinese, take the $30 million, and let the gangs deal with what they had to. Alex was about to hold the deal with Chang, but since the money has already been stolen, he tries to return to meet Luke instead. But Luke orders him to bring Mai along because she is an important asset. Alex follows the orders, kills Chang and his henchmen, and drives to meet Luke along with the girl. In the following scene, Luke breaks into the mayor's office and asks him for the contents of the second safe. Although the mayor is reluctant, he has no choice but to hand Luke a disc with the data. Luke knocks him out and returns to meet Alex like promised. With both the money and the information, he is the most powerful one in the game, but Alex has something more special. Mai. When the two finally meet to exchange Mai for the money, Luke refuses to cooperate, instead suggesting that they settle it with a fight. Alex gets ready but is shot in the leg by Mai. Taking the opportunity, Luke kills him with ease. He and Mai are finally free with the money and the disc that they can use for protection. For Mai's safety, Luke lets the captain free with $50,000 as compensation for his troubles. He also lets Vasily go so the Russians wouldn't come after them. Then there is the Chinese mafia leader, Han, who got his money and Mai stolen from him. Luke sends him all of the remaining money so he wouldn't try to look for Mai anymore. At last, he hides several copies of the disc throughout the city. In case someone tries to harm them, they can use the drive as a way to blackmail some powerful people. In the last scene, Mai and Luke drive to Seattle to start a new life. Subscribe for more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.